I don't know how they did it, but Dreamville managed to make a better album than Revenge of the Dreamers 3. They've got DJ Drama on it to make it feel like a mixtape, and the album cover is amazing. Seriously, look at that. Having the Dreamville members on the front and the imagery of war in the background is nuts. This is amazing. If there's a display, you best believe I'm getting it soon. In the beginning, they have their best opener to date with the song Stick. I remember when I heard it for the first time, I was completely floored. I thought to myself, how are they going to compete with their previous single for the last album, Down Bad? Well, this is their answer. Not only did they manage to compete with Down Bad, but they managed to outdo it in every aspect. Everything from the lyrics and the beat. But the main thing that carries the song is the energy brought in by Kenny Mason and Sheck West. The chorus is definitely something you can sing and shout in nearly every type of situation. I shouted this so many times with the windows down while driving, and it still hits to this day. J. Cole is the highlight of the song with him outdoing Jid, which is usually the opposite way around for me most of the time. J. Cole brought his A game and then some. You would think that being a multi-millionaire like him would leave him jaded as a rapper, but he proves us all wrong. Here, it feels like he has strong competition and he decides to remind everyone who he is, the head honcho. My favorite set of lyrics are his opening ones, which I repeat to myself all the time. These go, pray for me, God's got a place for me. Me and them are not standing adjacently. Bullet hit his mouth, at least he died tastefully. Good Lord has never forsaken me. In God I trust, so I get money faithfully. I know that was a lot, but that's how much it meant to. For anyone who doesn't like J. Cole, tell me, how could you hate on that? Another banger of a song is Lifestyle. This manages to keep the energy similar to the previous track mentioned, while having it slightly dialed down. This song features Bars and ASAP Ferg. The chorus is infectious as hell, and the beat definitely helps too. Both Bars and Ferg manage to provide a perfect blend of energy and smoothness on this track. Ferg has my favorite set of lyrics here with, I'm making a million a verse just like Swizzy and Timothy. Never provoke with the goat, cause all I want is a smoke. You could call me a chimney. Something about it feels so effortless right here. Next up, we've got one of the colder songs right here, Hair Salon. This might be one of my favorites. While it doesn't go as crazy as Stick, it's a smooth banger. The beat is a lot more laid back, which gives the rappers a lot more to play with here. The artists we have featured here are Cuz, G Perico, and Reason. The chorus combined with G Perico's voice gives me a feel similar to if Eazy-E was on a modern day beat. Reason also has a cold voice, with his being on the deep end. I call that a cheat code right there. Cuz easily has my favorite lyrics on here. They go, give us a reason, my people's rioting. I try to keep peace, but they trying it. It must be at least cause we is not buying it. Up next, we got my favorite song on this entire project, Barry from Simpson. Damn, bro, this hits hard. Dare I say, just as hard as Dick did. On here to represent for the crew, we've got Jid, 2 Chainz, and Young Nudie. Having Jid on a song has gotta be a cheat code, because every time he's up, he delivers. I love Jid for the same reason I love Ski Master Slump God. It's because of the way they deliver their verses and how they say things. I mean, they do also have great voices too. In verse 1, Jid is just warming up, but in the second verse, he's coming for everybody's necks. He has two sets of cold lyrics, so I'll start with the first one. Either you do or you don't do it, God put me to it, I'ma get it done. From a city that don't see the sun, I was buried from Simpsons. And then another one is, it didn't help me through it, homie had to work around the hood. But if heaven's waiting, what the hell we doing? You can't tell me that's not cold. His second set of lyrics go, I've been in fights and I didn't win and I didn't die, but they didn't live. So we did it right, better not get in if you're not gonna slide. I already knew Jid was a great rapper, but it's like he keeps on getting better. The fact that I haven't listened to his last album, The Forever Story, is blasphemy. Best believe that when I listen to it, you're gonna have a new review from me. So stay tuned for that. I wasn't the biggest fan of 2 Chainz when he first came up in terms of his lyrics, but within the last 5-6 years, his lyrics and flows have gotten much better. Here they're simple, but they hit. Time to move on to the last song from the album I'll be talking about today, Everybody Ain't Shit. This is an Earth Gang special right here. The chorus and the beat are among some of the smoothest here. Dr. Dot and Johnny Venus both go crazy in their own verses. My favorite lyrics from Dr. Dot go, we were struggling, hungry to get a placement. Don't let me get a foot in, you know I'm sticking my face in. Can't be humble and complacent. Sheesh! I gotta start listening to the Earth Gang. However, my favorite lyrics come from Johnny Venus, and they go, stay front and center like your dinner. Haters catch a whiff, you a winner. Then they enter, try to disconnect you from the paper like a printer. Damn! It's hard to say which one I like more, but both are definitely fire. Dreamville keeps getting better, and when they release their new album, best believe I'll be there. I'll see you guys in the next video, and this is Black Sugar Lovin', out!